What's going on, everyone? My name is Paul Tokizolu. Welcome back to the Beyond Homo Sapien podcast. I'm doing it from my car here in middle of nowhere, Missouri. It's nice and sunny outside, but it's also windy, and I want to preserve the audio quality here because I want to try to upload this to the podcast feed. So I haven't really done too many strict podcast episodes lately because I've been making a lot of shorter stuff. And I'm going to keep doing that. I'm doing a lot more. I'm going to try to do more on TikTok. So go follow me on TikTok at Beyond Homo Sapien if you are on the TikTok machine. Because it's a fun platform. And I like adding music to things. It's fun. But I want to talk today about this idea of, like, what can we do from home to help our world, to kind of, like, help our global community. And I really think that right now is the time to create some sort of a plan. We need to remember right now that our world leaders, that our elected officials, whether it's President Trump or whoever is running things in any country, whether that's Canada or Germany or the UK or Australia or wherever, they're just elected officials that are a manifestation of the collective whole. So even if you think that your voting system is flawed, we allow those flaws to continue to take place. You know what I mean? So by not being more active and more and holding these elected officials accountable, if that is what you think is going on. And that's kind of a conversation for another day. But what I'm trying to say here is that we have a responsibility to act, and we have a responsibility to make a plan and come up with our own solutions and start to engineer this kind of on the ground level, at the grassroots level. And that really can be the catalyst for mass change. That you really do have to be the change you want to see in the world. And that this is how this country in America got started. People coming up with plans and people coming up with different solutions to the different problems that came up in their communities. So that's what I'm advocating for today, is that a return to that, a return to that sort of innovation and engineering. Because right now in 2020, we have technologies that our ancestors could have never dreamed of. Like an example that I was thinking about earlier was Benjamin Franklin. Benjamin Franklin at my age was doing a lot of the similar stuff that I'm trying to do. He was innovating inside of the newspaper agency and inside of writing newspapers and writing books and writing things and trying to kind of pass along his message. And he was an entrepreneur and he was a business person in Massachusetts. And he eventually got involved in political activism and eventually in politics. And I'm interested in that sort of stuff. And I was thinking today about the tools that Benjamin Franklin had to accomplish his endeavor. You know, he had rudimentary, basic tools compared with what we have today. I'm making this video from rural middle of nowhere, Missouri. I'm literally sitting next to a cow pasture up here. And I'm able to make this video, which you can see anywhere. You can watch this wherever. You can watch it in any country. All you need is a phone and internet access or a computer. You know, you could go to your local library and consume this information if you had to. Or any information. So think about it in that way. Like, what could be engineered if you really realized just the broadcasting potential that we all have to broadcast a message, whatever it is, even if it's a message within your friend group on your social media feed, whether it's you write something or you make videos or you make a podcast or whatever, or maybe you make art, maybe you draw pictures to communicate, or you paint pictures to communicate, whatever. But you know what I mean? It's like we have so much ability here. We have so many different social media platforms. We have so many different ways to communicate and get across a message. And I was thinking today, what would Benjamin Franklin do? What would Thomas Paine do if they were in my shoes or in our shoes, anyone's shoes here, and they had all the tools that we have? And I'm not here advocating for some sort of a revolution, but more just an inventiveness and a return to the entrepreneurial spirit that really created this country and got things going, because now we have a lot of different tools and there's a lot more that we can do. And here's an example of what I'm talking about. Blockchain technology is something I've talked about on this show before. And if you're not familiar with blockchain, it's the technology that powers cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin or Ethereum. But really, the technology itself is what's the most interesting and I think the most compelling, especially if we're talking about changing our world politically or something like that, creating a more ideal system. Blockchain allows for secure transactions to happen over the internet. So I could send you money. I could send you all sorts of things. I could send you paperwork. I could send you the deed to my house. I could send you the paperwork, the title to this car over the blockchain. And it would be a secure transaction. And it could be something that anyone could validate to make sure that it actually happened. And in many ways, it could actually be considered more secure than if we did that transaction through the bank. And some people might argue it's even a more legitimate transaction if we do it through a blockchain technology versus going through a bank, because then you're using a third party system to kind of negotiate that transaction. And of course, there's a lot of complexities here. But really, my takeaway that I want you to take away from this is just that blockchain technology gives you the ability to send a secure transaction over the internet. And it could be anonymous, it could be secure, it could be linked to you if you wanted it to be. You know, it could be all sorts of things that you could be done with this technology. And there's already startups all over the world that are engineering how we could vote over the blockchain, how you could cast votes over the blockchain from your phone or from your computer. And that could involve logging into a secure network, using your social security number, or maybe uploading identification or something like that to prove that it's you logging in, and then you could vote through this online secure platform. And that's just one of many ideas. Imagine how much that would do for voting rights and for accessibility to vote, because that's a huge problem. We're seeing that right now. We saw that in this election with the Democrats. That voter, that people not being able to vote is a huge fucking issue. So if we want to engineer more freedom, and if we want to give people more of a voice and more of an ability to kind of participate in their political process, we need to make it easier for them to vote and for them to cast their votes. So if there was a blockchain voting system, which is being engineered already, this isn't an idea that I came up with necessarily, then you could cast your votes from anywhere in the world. Suddenly voting becomes easier. And really, voting is just a means of finding out what we all believe, what we all decide. And right now we kind of have these artificial dates of November in the United States as being our election day, and all this, that, the other thing. But really that's just because that's when it's, they have to organize it. It's such a big process because so much of it is in person. Right. So if there was some sort of a voting platform that we could establish over the blockchain technology or something similar, you could create a voting system that could be used anytime. We could be voting all the time, you know, taking polls and making consensus and figuring things out all the time amongst ourselves. Because if you think about it, the people that we elect in politics to the government, whether it's Congress or the House of Representatives or the presidency or whatever, they're just meant to be a representation of you. So it all got started back before this technology was ever even dreamed of, where we all had to send and elect a representative to go down to government to vote on our behalf. And that was because, in large part, because we couldn't go ourselves because there was no way to. It wouldn't be possible or feasible. People would die on the journey. So you elected a representative. But if you can vote over the internet, you could represent yourself, you know? And the argument against this is like, oh, it's complicated. It's very complicated. There's classified stuff they vote on. These issues are complex, blah, blah, blah. And I get that and I understand. But I'm sure that something here can be engineered or some sort of thing can be innovated, maybe a hybrid of the two. I've seen this been suggested before, that there still be a politician in place that represents the people, but that the politician has to vote in accordance with whatever is voted through this blockchain system. So really, this person is just meant to be a voice of the people, which is what they've always meant to be, right? So I like this plan. I like the hybrid plan a lot, of having a representative there who's handling all the business on the ground and giving a voice, you know, reading off whatever it is people have said, But really, that's what I think our politicians in large part should be, is take just existing to say, hey, this is what the people said. This is what my constituents said when I talked to them. And they don't do that right now very often. So blockchain or something of that variety allows us to have a more innovative system, more creative system, a more creative solution to this voting question that we all want to answer, hopefully. And I think that the people who don't want to allow us to all have a vote have a vested interest in making sure that this stuff doesn't happen. So we need to engineer it ourselves. And people are. That's the good news. Like I was saying, people are. This is an idea that is coming up into more and more prevalence. And it is happening, you know, one day at a time. But it's something that the people, I think, will have to demand and have to kind of manifest ourselves, because I don't think that the politicians are going to do it for us by very definition of what it is we're trying to do. So this blockchain example is just one example of how we might use technology to have a better system of government and a better system where we are all living together. And by very definition, this has never been done before, right? Because this technology has never existed. And we could also get into talking about artificial intelligence, about virtual reality, augmented reality, and a lot of these other kind of new technologies, like cryptocurrency too. I mean, is this kind of own thing as far as currency is concerned? I mean, there's a lot to be discussed here. There's a lot that can be implemented. There's a lot that can be invented and engineered, and we can kind of come up with a lot of new solutions. But it's in ways that have never been done before, right? And it might span different countries. It might not look like, oh, just one country or one town existing independently. We might be moving towards a more global economic system. But I think that this sort of a thing is what we need to do. You know what I mean? So I think that the plan, this innovative idea of how we're going to best live together, has to come from the people. It's not going to come from the politicians. And we've seen that. Like, they exist within one system. You know, they're not going to invent a new system that is different than their system. And I'm not talking necessarily about communism or socialism or anything like that, because I don't think that those work either. I think that we've seen that those also don't work. I think we need something new that utilizes the new tools that are recently invented, like the internet, like the thing that we're using right now to communicate with each other to get this message. So, you know, there's a lot that is recent inventions that we can utilize to kind of innovate our world and change things around and just make things a lot easier for ourselves. But it's going to take a lot of engineering, and it's going to take a lot of discussion, and it's going to take us planning and figuring this out and setting some goals and kind of brainstorming and talking about this. So I'm going to be writing a book on this topic. I've already started. It's going to be called The Master Plan to Save the World. And it's this idea that we need to create some sort of a plan. And the book is going to be kind of my attempt at what I think that plan should be from a macro level. But the whole point of it is that it's meant to be a collaborative effort. That by very nature of this sort of thing, I think that we all need to put together a master plan to save the world, is what I'm saying. So I'm going to do my best to set an example and write a book on the topic. But I would encourage you to also do the same, you know, or write a book or write on it a journal on this topic of how can you make a master plan to save the world? What would you do if you had to save the world? What would you do if God came down to you and said, hey, you need to save the world, put together a plan? You know what I mean? And so what I'm going to do is I'm also going to put together a subreddit on Reddit, because I really like Reddit a lot. So go to Reddit and you can join the Beyond Homo Sapien subreddit. And just search Beyond Homo Sapien on Reddit and you can join the community. Or you can go to beyondhomosapien.com/master-plan. And you can find the link there for the online community. And of course, it's all totally free. So I would love to put together kind of a think tank. I would love to put together a community of people who can contribute online and put together some sort of a plan, and see what that looks like. Maybe it's something that just is applied to just our lives at the individual level, or maybe it's something that is at a more macro scale and whether that looks like something that might be submitted to local governments or maybe something that is created into a new form of government altogether. Haha, the wind picked up when I said that. And that's what I'm feeling too, is that we need something new. Some sort of independent state. I don't know. But we'll see. But that's, I guess, where this conversation needs to go. So go to Reddit and go join the Beyond Homo Sapiens subreddit. And it's going to serve kind of as an online think tank for this master plan to save the world. So go check it out and invite anyone who you think might want to contribute. And if you have ideas, please write them. Please share them. I think that the big issues that we need to address starting forward with are education, obviously the economy, but I think that that's tied in with education, is that if people are educated properly, they'll have a lot more ability to make money and create additional streams of income. And I think that we need to kind of pave the way more for more people to become entrepreneurs, more people to kind of embrace their own purposes and their own passions. And people have tools to do that now more than ever, but obviously there's a lot more to consider. And that's what I think is gonna happen. So I want to create this online think tank. So go to Reddit, go join the Beyond Homo Sapien subreddit, and I'll see you there. So much love to you. Thanks for watching. Do me a favor, share this video, give it a like, and comment, and let me know what you think. And do you have a master plan to save the world? Let me know. So I think a lot of people might have a secret little master plan to save the world, at least in the back of their heads or something. Maybe stuff they talk about with friends, maybe stuff they've made on video before. But whatever it is, I want to put it all together. You know, I want to share it. That's the point of this subreddit, is I want it to be a place where you can come and share the blog post you wrote a year ago about this sort of stuff. Or maybe you and your friends have been talking about it and you made a YouTube video. I want to see that YouTube video. Stuff like that. So go check it out. Go check out this Beyond Homo Sapiens subreddit. And let's save the world. Why not? Someone's got to do it. It's not going to be Trump or Bernie Sanders, I don't think. Let's go do it. So check it out, and I'll talk to you guys soon.